Hello, I'm Dr. John Daly, Chief Medical Officer of COLA. In the top 10 list of patient safety concerns for 2016, ECRI Institute listed patient misidentification as one of the top 5 concerns. This is a serious issue and one which merits reflection and discussion in the clinical laboratory. Patient identification errors can occur at multiple steps in the life cycle of a laboratory test, most notably in the pre-analytic phase of testing. In part, this is because there can be multiple individuals involved and multiple manual steps in the ordering, collection, labeling, and transmission of a given specimen. Today, I just want to focus on the identification of the patient and specimen container at the time of specimen collection. In collecting a blood specimen, the phlebotomist should be required to have the patient state the two patient identifiers by asking, "What is your name and date of birth?" The phlebotomist should not state, "Are you?" and then give the patient name and the date of birth, with the patient being allowed to nod the head in agreement. I have personally witnessed errors in identification with erroneous result reporting as a result of an improper identification being obtained from the patient at the time of phlebotomy. Now, a specimen container or blood tube must be labeled at the time of collection in the presence of the patient, so there is no interruption or distraction which could lead to improper labeling. If pre-printed labels are used, there must be a policy that unused labels are destroyed immediately so as not to be available for use with an incorrect patient. Remember, patient or specimen misidentification during specimen procurement will follow through the entire testing process, potentially culminating in results being reported on an incorrect patient. This can lead to inappropriate follow-up with unnecessary additional testing, both in the clinical laboratory and also potentially imaging studies, improper treatment regimen, and unnecessary consultations. Incorrect patient identification with incorrect reporting can also lead to a patient not being followed up for an existing condition, leading to a delay in the diagnosis. Remember also that laboratory errors can have a financial and, more importantly, an emotional effect on both patients and their loved ones. Thank you for your attention.